Okay, Pastor.
Hello. Okay, so last time that
on the record, so,
on
the record.
Karino sa kanya.
I said it was the Catholic Church because Hillary could not surpass its cruelty. And and the cruelty will manifest itself. I have additional current event. Maybe well, everyone is aware of the war in Syria, right? And something remarkable has happened. Russia has successfully co-authored a peace agreement, temporary peace agreement with Turkey. And if you know, Russia and Russia and Turkey are two of the protagonists in Ezekiel 38-39. They are allies in Ezekiel 38-39. These are six nations which will attack Israel. And the cruelty of the woman will, the final manifestation is in the middle of the week when she kills the two prophets and takes over the Temple Mount. Not just the Temple Mount, the temple itself. Now, Ezekiel 38-39 war will be caused by the temple rebuilding. Because Israel is a land without borders, without walls anymore. Right now, she has walls. Now, one day, the Mosque of Omar, as Pastor Thomas said, will be destroyed. And it will be replaced by a final temple, the third temple, prophesied in Haggai. So, when this temple, what is going to be erected, it will be the site where the two prophets will prophesy for 3.5 years. So, but before that happens, Ezekiel 38-39 war will take place. And if you read the two chapters, God will intervene. God will save Israel. Take note, Israel is still rejecting the Messiah, even though she pretends like Christians love her. She's like deceiving the Christians to love her, okay, to support her against the Palestinians. But the time she will wake up is in the time of the two prophets. The two prophets will open up her eyes. It's the time when the 144,000 will be seen, and the 144,000 are the brethren of Jesus Christ, like Joseph meeting up with his brethren while leaving his wife in the room. Leaving. So, the temple will be erected. First, the war. The temple will be erected to cause the war. Because Brother Branham talked about the riches of the world. Half held by the Jews, half held by the Catholics. That's why she's cool. And when these two unite, they'll control the whole world. They always say, whoever controls Jerusalem controls the world. So, when the temple will be erected, everyone wants to make it their headquarters. The Pope has always called upon Jerusalem to be made an international city for three faiths, Jews, Muslims, Christians. They just coexist peacefully. But when the two prophets will take over the scene, barring others from the temple site, they will be laid in a siege and the city will be trodden underfoot 42 months, 3.5 years. And while they're prophesying, they could not enter the temple premises. For 3.5 years, they could not be killed. But after they're killed, that's the time the cruelty starts. After killing the two prophets, she will influence the world so that the world's police will look upon these believers of the two prophets as terrorists, and they will be hunted down and be martyred. That's where the ultimate cruelty will take place again. So What happens after the war? And God intervenes. It is God who saved Israel, but the Pope will take the credit. The Pope will make a covenant with many. As the Pope can make a covenant with many for 1 week, that's the time that the two prophets starts this ministry in the temple for 3.5 years. So when the Pope makes a covenant with many, it's a deceptive peace. And this is the time when Father Storpa said, the time of the rapture. You don't know the day or the hour, but certain events will transpire for you to know, for you to see. How long will Ezekiel 38-39 take place? And how will we be able to see the covenant? When the peace covenant is signed, it is the beginning of the tribulation period. The beginning of that last week. The beginning of this. It's also the rapture season. And the beginning of two prophet ministry. Now, Russia, who is normally antagonistic with Turkey, they have become allies in order to forge a peace deal in Syria. This could be a stepping stone for that to happen because they're one of the six allies. Let me list out the other allies. There's Ethiopia. There is Libya. There is Armenia, which before I've been looking for it. It just came out in 1991 when Russia broke up. I've been looking for this country before 1991. I couldn't find it because it was part of the Soviet Union, but she has broken up. So God was gradually setting the stage for that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What's the last one? Kush, Libya, Ethiopia.
Iran.
Iran, yes. Iran is a superpower right now. Iraq is no more. Before it was Iraq who is the superpower, Saddam Hussein. Now it's Iran. So God is setting the stage.
What did Trump do? He
wants to call off the agreement made by Obama on Iran. So Iran might have the excuse to make nuclear weapons again. But she will not be able to use that because if you read the prophecy there, she will be destroyed as she becomes allies with this attacking Israel. God will intervene and make their arms fire each other, just like it happened in time of Gideon. So that's the current events right now. God bless. Anyway, I'm going to repeat it. If ever I said it before. Melchizedek is a epitome of the being the Son of Man. Branham said he's a prophet. Jesus Christ was the prophet of God, and he manifested it in the seven stars in his right hand. Now those who follow those star messengers, you yourself will become a star. That's in Daniel chapter 12 verse 3. Could you open up? If you turn many to righteousness, you'll be as the stars in the firmament in heaven forever. I'm going to add other terminologies like the morning star. Being a prophet, you bring many to righteousness. And let's talk about revealing the mysteries. As an Old Testament prophet, Brother Branham could have a word of knowledge of the secrets of the hearts of men. In the Old Testament, you don't need a Bible to prove it. You just look if the event comes to pass, then it's vindicated. But here in the New Testament, you don't rely on those supernatural things as the ultimate vindication because the devil can counterfeit that supernatural experience. What the devil could not counterfeit right now is the revealing of the mysteries in the Word. Amos 3:7, the Lord will do nothing but reveal His secrets to His servants, the prophets. First to Brother Branham, then to the bride. And what mysteries are they? It is not a supernatural mystery of knowing the secrets of the hearts of men. Some denominations have done that. I'm talking about, in the Word of God, certain mysteries will be opened up because you found in the ministry of the prophet, the prophet led the way for you to see things that he that was in the written in the Bible, but what could not yet be understood before, but it was revealed in the last days, the sons of men. That's the fulfillment of Revelation 10:11. You must prophesy again to many nations, tongues, and kings. I would like to add, it's also what Christ said. He that receive a prophet in the name of the prophet will receive the prophet's reward. The reward you receive is how he had his relationship with Jesus Christ. It's not the person of him, but it's just the Eliezer that pointed you to Isaac. And you, when you are united with Isaac, you will have a relationship with Isaac. You yourself will receive the same gift of revelation from the Word of God with your relationship to Jesus Christ. Now, I'd like to point out here in Melchizedek. Melchizedek was described as without father, without mother, without beginning of days, nor end of life. Now, this was foreshadowed, typified to Jesus Christ, but we will become one with Jesus Christ. We also will become Melchizedek, just as Jesus Christ was. Thou art a priest forever, after the order of Melchizedek. If you become a priest, that is the royal priesthood said by Peter in 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 5. Verse 9. A royal priesthood, a holy nation. So, if being priests, right now, you are ministering servants of God, not just the ministers, as Barwell said. It's not just the theologian or the leader or the pastor, it's the whole church. The bride will have a ministry, a very humble ministry. It's the whole church will be ministers of the word, who will witness, be witnesses. Being a minister to the word, you don't just share the word, you also minister on their needs. So, being without father, how about being without father, without mother? We have our mothers and fathers in the flesh. When we become this royal priesthood, we are no longer part of the earthly realm like we came from our parents. Melchizedek was compared with Aaron or Levi. You cannot become a priest unless your parentage are priests. You cannot become, you need to be in the lineage of priests to become priest. But in the order of Melchizedek, you just need to receive an oath. This oath is revelation, this is a call, a calling, this is a vocation, that you're called. And you're chosen. And you receive this word. It's just a pre-qualification to become a royal priest. And when you become without father, without mother, without beginning of days nor end of life, you become connected to the eternal, to the deep, as the deep calls to the deep. You are no longer your parents' children. You are already sons of God. You're adopted into his kingdom. When you become sons and daughters of God, you're directly connected to God. Even your parents could be your brothers and sisters in Christ. And your own parents, who are your brothers and sisters in the Lord, will be your brethren in the Lord. We're all sons and daughters of God, under God, and we are made into a holy priesthood, a holy nation. Even in the resurrection, you will be priests forever. You will be ministering priests forever. So, I'd like to point out here in the description of Melchizedek, without father, without mother, but made like unto the Son of God. You'll be made like to Jesus Christ. Just as Melchizedek was, so will the bride be. Without father, without mother, without descent. You're no longer reliant upon descent to be the sons and daughters of God or to be priests. You're not under the order of Aaron that you need a lineage to become priest. All you need is an oath. So, you will receive the power of an endless life. you receive a priesthood that comes from another tribe, the power of an endless life. So the ministry of the Son of God, from Jesus Christ to the prophet, down to the bride. I'd like to add another description about the man-child in Revelation chapter 12. The man-child, I didn't finish reading the books, but I already mentioned it was Jesus Christ. Now, if you read Revelation chapter 12 carefully, it's not just in the time of Jesus Christ, it will be afterwards. This man-child will be caught up to God. The dragon will try to kill the man-child. We could connect to the message a while ago. Who will kill the Catholic Church? It's like the dragon who wants to kill the child. But she survived. The woman survived, but the child overcame and was caught up to heaven. That's what was written in Revelation chapter 12. And this child will be given rod to rule with a rod of iron. This will take place in the millennium. Now, this man-child initially was said to be Jesus Christ. But if Jesus Christ has become one with the church will be that manifestation of this man-child ruling. And that rulership will be in the millennium. So, just to add to it, let me connect the cruelty of the woman, another woman, the dragon, riding a dragon, trying to kill the man-child. Now, the man-child has been caught up. In Revelation chapter 12, there is also called the remnant of her seed. These are tribulation saints. The dragon will go after the remnant of her seed. These are they that are left behind after the man-child has been caught up. So, the Son of Man ministry will still continue during the tribulation period through the remnant of her seed, starting from the two prophets, which is parallel to the prophet, then the 144,000. The 144,000 will be this remnant of the seed that the dragon will pursue. So, it's the last continuation of the Son of Man ministry until the end. So, those who are part of the first resurrection, they will all be in this royal priesthood. Even in the glorified body state, they will be priests of God in His temple in different capacities. So that's just my contribution. God bless.